everyone, I am Jamie Palmer, online business strategist and simplifier for driven entrepreneurs who want to build and scale an online business. I am the creator of the program Business Ecosystem Builders that works with entrepreneurs, course creators, and service providers who want to focus on one signature program so that they can create more freedom in their lives. In today's video, I am going to share with you some pro Zoom tips. Yes, I am talking all of the fun and little known features in Zoom, like touch up your appearance, adding people to meetings automatically as long as they're signed in, and all sorts of other features that are gonna up your game when it comes to being on Zoom video. Be sure to stay tuned all the way to the end for my bonus tip. If you are enjoying this content and you want to get more business building and online marketing tips, be sure to hit subscribe. Every single Tuesday, I put out new videos like this that help you grow and scale your online business. I started using Zoom in my business as soon as it became available. I hated Skype because it made my computer so slow, and I hated the fact that GoToMeeting had all sorts of software that also slowed my computer down. And for the most part, I was doing phone calls with clients, and that kind of led to some boundary issues. At least for me, I would have clients call me after hours and text me all times of the day, and it really became a very stressful thing for me in my business. So when Zoom came available and I could move all of my clients into a video conferencing piece of software and didn't have to give out my personal cell phone number, I was like, oh heck yes, sign me up. So today, Zoom, we use it all the time. We use it to get in touch with friends and family. We use it for work. We use it for everything in between. And so why not look the best that you can possibly look and be a Zoom pro? So that's what I'm going to share with you today. All sorts of Zoom ninja tips to help you show up, look better online, and become a Zoom pro. Okay, so you head on over to zoom.us and you will log into your account here. So as you can see, you can go under the meeting section here and you will be able to see kind of all of the different meetings that you have. But if you go into schedule a meeting, I'm going to walk you through some different features that make life a lot easier when going through and setting up a Zoom. So one of the things that you can do is you can schedule meetings that reoccur. So you would go into here and you would say, this is a recurring meeting. And you would say when this recurs, how this recurs, and all of that fun information. And then that meeting will automatically show up in your Zoom app on your desktop, which makes it really, really easy to just get in and out of meetings. And especially if you have commitments that happen on a regular basis, this is a great way for both you and the client to really just simply and easily have access to that meeting on a regular basis. So one of the things that I love and hate about Zoom right now is the whole process of admitting people into my meeting. So what I've done is I've actually disabled the password and I've turned off this required. And what I've done is I've done require authentication to join. So what that means is that someone has to be signed into a Zoom account so that they can actually join the call. So what I do is I remove the waiting room and then I require authentication to sign in. And this is really great if you are working with your team and, you know, you don't have a public Zoom that you use. It becomes really easy to just turn this off. That way you don't have to, as the host, worry about paying attention to make sure that you admit people into the meeting. And that makes a really big difference, at least for me, in terms of making sure that I don't have to worry about that. So the other things that you can do in this back end is you can also say, I want my video turned off. I want participant video turned off when you sign in. And you can do the same thing
for audio. The other thing that I like to do is I have to record a lot of my meetings. So I will also hit this button where I automatically record the meeting. You can record it to the local computer or you can record it in the cloud, whichever works for you. That's another really great setting. Now, as I'm walking you through this, understand that you have to go through and do this for each one of the individual meetings that you have. But once you do it and you do it once, it's all set up. So those are kind of some of my favorite tools that I like to use when it comes to Zoom. The other thing that you can do here is you can go under advanced and you can look at the app marketplace, and in the app marketplace are all the different tools with which you can connect Zoom. So a couple of my personal favorites that I use are Slack. I also use it for Google Drive and Google Team and Gmail. And I also use it for my Calendly app. So those are the three that I use the most. And it's super easy to come in here and just kind of click and integrate the things that you want to integrate because you just sign in and the rest is done for you. So let me know in the comments if you have any other questions for me with respect to Zoom. Hey everyone, so I am going to share some of my Zoom tips and tricks. So let's get started. So as you can see, one of my favorite apps is Zoom, and I am going to share with you guys kind of how to get yourself set up with the gallery mode. So when someone comes into a meeting, over here on the right hand side, you'll see that there is a tab that pops up when someone is there that says view. And in that view, you can have it be on the speaker mode or the gallery mode. I prefer to have the gallery mode because it's a really easy way in which you can kind of visually see everyone who is on the call. Now, the next thing that I want to share with you is one of my favorite features on here is the touch up your appearance. So if you were to go over into in your settings in the app, you go over to preferences. And in the preferences, as you can see here, you've got my Yeti microphone and you have all of these different things. So here is a lot of the places where you can set different things. So you can use dual monitors, you can enter full screen, always show meeting controls, ask me to confirm when I leave a meeting, show meeting duration, stop video when my display is off or screensaver begins. You can remind me before meetings. You could also choose your skin tone. That's like the general setting. So we'll just play around with this. I'm very white. So I'll switch to that color rather than this awkward yellow emoji color. And then under video settings, here I am again. What you can do is you can have this set up as original video, HD, or mirror. And I like to have the mirror set up so it shows up properly. And then you'll see here that you can have this touch up your appearance. And as you can see, I'll move this out of the way, it adds different layers of the filter onto my video. So I always have some layer of touch up your appearance on because it just kind of cleans up your video and makes you look a little bit more professional. The other thing that you want to adjust here is adjust for low light. So particularly in my office, I have a window behind me. So in the afternoon when it's sunny in here, I can look backlit and it looks kind of funny, and that will auto adjust for that. The other thing that you can always do is ask the display participant name in their videos, turn off your video when joining a meeting, and all these other options. So as you can see, there's a lot of different ones here. So you can go through and have a lot of fun with playing around in there, but that touch up appearance is under the video option. The other one that you can have is in the video. So you can have different colors here for your chat. And then of course, as you've probably seen, is the backgrounds with Zoom. So you can choose different backgrounds. They almost never work for me. So I'm not even gonna try. I'm just going to turn that off because my camera is too far away. But those work really well if you're close to the camera. And you can add studio effects. You can also add video filters onto what you're doing, and that will create different effects depending upon what it is that you want to do. So you could put on, as you can see, this fun hat or this fun headband, and you could also switch out your background. So there's lots of different fun things that you can do with your Zoom. So that's under the backgrounds and filters. Now, again, I like to come in here too and look at some of the recording settings, but the vast majority of the other settings that we're going to get into today are going to come when you visit Zoom on the website.
Which one of my ninja tips are you going to implement right away? Let me know in the comments. If you haven't already and you want more information like this, be sure to get on the waitlist for my new program, The Foundation. This is a 90-day intensive program that helps you get all the pieces in place that you need to grow and scale your business online. Head on over to www.thefoundation.systems and get on the waitlist. One of the best ways to let me know that you're enjoying this content is to like and comment below, and of course, share with a business bestie. Thank you so much for tuning in, and have a fantastic day.